SUV. I just came back for the win. Lot of new money in my hand. Go on, tell a friend, tell a friend. We are just inside the Beltway, about 10 miles east of the Capitol Dome, as we come to you from FedEx Field here in Landover. Today, it's a Week 9 matchup set to go here between the Miami Dolphins and the Washington Commanders. First 2 months of the regular season down. What will the final two bring us as we're off in Week 9? And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Gibson, and a short pickup to about the 27. It'll be second down. This defense, Charles, really played well in that win a week ago.
But we certainly had a nice conversation with the defensive coordinator, didn't we? And what we heard, I like what we did, but we definitely need more pressure on the quarterback this week.
The last run got a couple here, second and 8. They fake the give. Now Wentz. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield. But they never did.
An early tough test on the opening drive. This is third and 8. Wentz now to throw. Trying to get it to Thomas, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Javon Holland, and the Dolphins are going to take possession of the football.
Part of why they came to this week with a winning record is that they feed off of mistakes like this, and now it's a prime opportunity, just moments in the game, to get a short field touchdown off of their big defensive play. Now on the other side, they were already the underdog in this one. They just made their uphill battle just a little bit tougher.
First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. That one caught, and oh, it coughed it up. And it's Washington that scoops it up. And now off to the races, down the right side. Pass the 20. And he is going to bring this one back to the house. It's a Commanders touchdown on the scoop and score. And he has great speed, defensive back speed. Once he got it and took off, there was no catching him.
And I know every team tells you to hustle no matter what the play, but there was no chance of catching him. Maybe if it had been a defensive tackle running with the ball, but not in this case.
Extra point by Sly is up and good, and it's now a 7-0 game.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return.
From a yard or two deep, here comes a return.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And you know, certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in first place in their division, looking really good and looking to be a threat come January.
And are you one of those early holiday shoppers, partner? Are you one of those guys, get your list done? Because I think about what every team has on their holiday shopping list right now. What's the number one goal? Make the playoffs. Number two, win your division. Number three, and I think the biggest goal of all, try to get the number one seed so you get that first round bye and ensure you don't have to go anywhere in January and hopefully get to the Super Bowl that way.
And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
I know what you're thinking out there. I know a lot of you are thinking, take a shot downfield. It's a great spot for it. I'd say maybe later in the game, definitely in the second half. But right now, I think they were just trying to get some momentum built. Get a first down, pick it up, and keep moving.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Tua gonna throw. Getting this out to the flat, Mostert. The result, only 4 yards there on the play, and it'll be second down.
I tell you what, CD, this Washington defense, very strong in the victory last week.
I have to admit, I was extremely impressed by what I saw on tape because they stayed in the face of the quarterback the entire game, ended up getting 4 sacks total, and made it difficult for him to step up and find receivers downfield. Also made it hard for him to escape the pocket and run.
From the 36, Tua. Got a man complete to Cedric Wilson. And they're going to get this up to midfield.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Second and 6 at the 46-yard line.
Down. Anchor. Go anchor.
Straight. A pitch out to Mostert. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. That's going to go down as a loss of 5, and it brings up third down. Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Man, it starts with the guys up front, so when you talk with GMs who are putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out, because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game, and that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
Like you.
Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. All the Commanders are going to get there as he's taken down. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
For a rookie first rounder, he's made a huge impact on this defense, but that tells me that they had a plan for him when they drafted him. Just turn him loose, do what you do best, go get the quarterback.
He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. Taking it about the 16. A 40-yard punt, giving 3 on the return. And the Commanders will take over with a first and 10. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
They've got a 7-0 lead in the football as well as they start out first and 10. Here's Gibson to start the drive. And some room to maneuver. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first. Looked like they picked a heck of a time to run the counter.
And we've been saying that in this great game of football probably since we started playing. Anytime you get guys thinking you're going to go one way and you hit back the opposite side, it's a great chance it can turn into the type of play we just saw there, a big gainer.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Wentz going to throw. To the sideline. Wow, what a catch. Doesn't get a lot out of it, but he is able to keep the feet in bounds.
Was that a receiver? Yeah, actually it was. It was a running back who was a receiver on the play. Ikey's been spending time in the receiver drills getting his feet down.
Well, those guys out of the backfield, they got to be good, agile with their feet. He showed the agility there with a toe tap.
No doubt about it. It's like he'd run to ballet school. Got the toes down and stayed in bounds.
To throw again on second down. Wentz back to Gibson and another catch for him. And they're going to get this up to midfield. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
They'll come to the line needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Midfield. Here's Wentz. Pressure comes and down he goes.
Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
Well, they were able to win last week despite him being sacked 4 times. They might need to tighten the reins a little bit or this one may not end in another victory.
You're right about that. They can't count on just winning the game no matter what happens. They can't let the accumulation of hits and harassment in the pocket get to their quarterback. Got to stop that. Give him clean lanes to throw the football in order to have a better chance to win again this week.
That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time, and it'll be Dolphin football. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts. Mostert hit, and he drops the ball. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. 2nd and 10 coming up.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free. But a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. Able to hang on to the ball this time, and in the process picks up the first down.
How many times do we say in this game is speed kills? And it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifting, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down.
Here we go.
In motion right is Wilson. Setting to throw on first down is Tua. He'll get this into the hands of Mostert. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43.
And they'll use him out of the backfield and sometimes quite a bit. They're just trying to get him touches any way they can. 4 catches a week ago, there's another one right there.
Tua now on first down. Open man downfield is Hill.
And he's going to get this down near the 25. That's what we're used to seeing from him right there. Plays like that, why he's number four in the league in terms of receiving yardage.
Able to make adjustments all along the way. Doesn't matter where he lines up, where he releases from. Working his way into the secondary, figures out defenses and finds weak spots in order to get open.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Here's Tua. That's going to be caught by Waddle. And he's brought down here just outside of the 20.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Tua to throw again. And his throw is incomplete. He was looking for Tyreek Hill that time, but now it's third down.
He could have scanned downfield forever, but there wasn't anything available. Ends up throwing an incompletion, and I think he'll take that.
Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on third and six. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. That's Daron Payne with a sack that time.
Well, obviously the pass rush gets the glory and the statistics on this play. But the coverage, they deserve a ton of credit too. Denied open windows. Erased the quarterback's targets one by one. Everywhere he looked, someone was covered. Only a matter of time before someone got there to bring him down.
The kick by Lambeau is good, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So that kick gives them their first points of the game, CD, and it comes on the third drive, but hopefully for them that's a spark that gets that offense going.
Yeah, and I would say if you're the offensive play caller, as you look at your sheet, you're trying to find that part on there that unlocks bigger points. They've struggled with a few drives so far. Finally got three out of it. How do you find the end zone? That's what he's searching for now.
Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. And it's been a rocky start for them thus far. They had the turnover and then the punt on those first two drives.
So there is optimism because they've improved, right? Turnover, you just noted it.
Punt's
on the first
better.
Drive.
Punt's better than the turnover.
The punt is better on the second one. Now they're hoping to turn into first downs and hopefully points.
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a second and three. Decided to hand it off that time on the run-pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice, steady gain.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a second and 3. Here's Wentz to throw. That's out to the flat for Gibson. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Well, they certainly made a point of getting him involved in the passing game here in the first half. They must have seen something in the scouting that said, hey, we can capitalize on him getting the ball, possibly in the open field. And I think in the second half, that may loosen up the defense a little bit to get the running game going back inside.
Wentz now on first down. Now he's going to drop this one down to Gibson, and they'll take him down at the 31-yard line.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
from the 31. Wentz. That's complete. Terry McLaurin with it. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. His first catch, good for 16 and a first. And this is a guy who last week not only helped his real team, but really helped a lot of fantasy teams. Three trips to pay dirt, they've got to contain him.
And watching him play is like going to lunch with you when you order that combo plate, right? In this case, his combo plate is he can go over the top of you and catch it in front, turn it into a big gain, run past you, and then uses his size and his physical abilities to keep you away from the football. Hard to defend this guy.
Reigning NFC Offensive Player of the Week. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Once more, Gibson. Call it a gain of five there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Two minutes to play in this first half. 7-3, our score. Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number seven on third and two. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0-for-3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get to third down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on first and second down.
To throw for it on fourth. That's to his running back complete. And he is going to have a Washington first down. They didn't get a lot, but they do convert on fourth. Fourth and two, they got it. That was kind of that gray area. Is that a feel thing, whether you go run or pass there offensively?
I think it's a feel thing. It's a tendency thing about what you like to do yourself on offense, as well as knowing how strong they are against the run on defense. Got to make a decision, and they made the correct one.
On first and 10, here's Wentz. He completes this one to Terry McLaurin. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. 25 yards that time.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
On first and 10, it's Gibson. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Wentz. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so he went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a third and eight. Straight ahead, Gibson. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. And Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. Halfway there, down to the 1 yard line. Second and goal from the one. They'll try and run. This is Robinson. And we're going to get a timeout. With 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter, it's a loss of two. Now third down. So with 2 ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle. Sly able to put this one through. And that will do it for this first half. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. The Dolphins down on the scoreboard, but they'll have it first as we get going in this third quarter. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive.
Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
They fake the handoff. Now Tua. That's going to be caught. Now a loose football. The ball comes out. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. You probably talked about this training camp. knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Tua sets up to pass it. That's complete to Mostert out of the backfield. And the tackle going to be made at the 38.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
Here we go.
Second and 8 coming up. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9.
I think this running game, or should I say lack of one, is making this defense look better than what they really are.
They'll need to get it to the 30 for a first. This is third down. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
Online, but off the crossbar, no good. A long-range effort denied 3 points at the very end. All things considered, a pretty good kick. Just cruel punishment there to be denied by the crossbar.
If you're going to hit from that distance, sometimes you're going to need a little luck. And unfortunately for him, this time the break goes against him.
Out there set ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
We have not seen much on offense here from either side these last few drives. We've hit a wall, so to speak.
And have hit it hard, haven't we? Because the defenses right now, they seem to be a step ahead, don't they? Beating them to the point of attack, beating them to the punch. These offensive guys, they're tinkering like crazy. What's it going to take to get back on track?
Yeah, both sides searching for adjustments. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Throwing is Wentz. And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes.
That time, multiple defenders getting pressure, and it's a loss of 6.
I'm sure a lot of time was spent in the locker room, Charles, with talking with his defense about setting a tone here in the third quarter when you're down on the scoreboard. A sack like that, maybe that can get them going.
Yeah, you have to believe exactly what you just said, that they got together and said, let's be some change agents here. Let's go ahead and turn things around. Let's be the force that gets us going here in the second half and puts us in a position to find a way to win the game.
Got this complete to Jahan Dotson. And he's going to have a Commanders first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Whenever we talk about moving the sticks and controlling the football, there's a great example right there. Those are the third downs you need to convert to win football games. We're in the third quarter of this one, and this is a tight one. In order to maintain pace, keep the ball away from the other team, and put points on the board, those are the plays they need to continue to convert.
Throwing on first is Wentz. That'll be caught. It's the tight end Howard. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain.
It doesn't look like this defense found the magic elixir at halftime. This offense was rolling in the first half, and that's continued here in the third quarter. Another big play right there.
So now, following the big play, they've got a first and goal all the way down at the 10.
Money, money.
A give up the middle to Gibson.
And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
I think sometimes when you're trying to get after the quarterback, maybe it's better to be lucky than great. Because I think on that one, he's just trying to get upfield and rush the passer. Instead, the tackle for the loss landed right in his lap.
And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Call it a gain of 3 on the play. And 3rd and 8 now.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
Seventh play of the drive, forthcoming on 3rd and 8.
A give to Gibson running right.
And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. They'll get 6 there on the run, but it brings up 4th down.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard.
Wentz to the sideline on 4th down. Joey Sly is out there now for the Washington field goal.
From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle.
Sly able to put this one through.
So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him. And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
There he was in the slot for the catch.
Knifes his way forward here, but just 3 yards on the play, second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Now a play fake. Here's Tagovailoa. And he cannot avoid the pressure as the Washington pass rush gets home. Deron Payne picks up his 2nd sack of the afternoon.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in 3rd and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
Throwing is Tagovailoa on 3rd down here. He is going to find Hill here. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter.
double.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Looking to pass. Tua. And this is caught inside the five. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Jalen Waddle, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Dolphins have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. After by Lambeau, up and good. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. That last touchdown has made this really tight. They're clinging now to this slim lead. What, Jesus, second half, they only have a field goal. This offense needs to kick it into gear.
And right now, I'm looking directly at the field general, at the quarterback, because to me, he's got to take over right now. By word, pumping his team up, and then, of course, by deed with his play. My school coach used to say that all the time.
Laddie,
take over by word and deed.
And deed means action.
Exactly.
From the 24, Wentz. Middle of the field, he's got McLaurin. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. That one good for 26 and a first down.
And these guys certainly not hiding what their intention is. They're absolutely showing it. They're definitely not going to sit on this lead here in the fourth quarter.
Gibson here running out of the gun. And some space here. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30. 82 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Calling no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. And Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this.
On second down, a run with Gibson.
They'll get it to the 23-yard line. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. And I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently.
Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. Washington on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. Now Wentz. That's going to be caught. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the 1. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
And that certainly appears to be a critical conversion right there, because not only do they keep the drive going, they take valuable time off the clock as well. They have to feel really good about that last completion.
So 1st and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Gibson will score. Touchdown, Commanders. So the first drive ended in 3. This time they take it down and punch it in the end zone.
So that first drive felt like they were just gathering knowledge, didn't it? Just enough to kick the field goal on the first one. And the second time they put it all together and got it all the way to the end zone.
The extra point by Sly is up and good. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is going to be returned from middle of the end zone. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. And he takes it all the way across the 40 before going out of bounds.
There's no downplaying that we all knew that this was a critical possession. And to get a return like that to start things off, that's the spark that they needed. That's the spark they were looking for.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. Well, that last touchdown we just saw, what an important one. Now it's back to a 2-score deficit for this crew as they take the field here, and they are in desperate need of finding the end zone. A quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. Two are going to throw. A quick throw knocked away and incomplete.
And they approach this drive with a lot of confidence after the last one ended up as a touchdown. But incompletions on the first 2 throws has them hovering up and trying to figure out a big play here on 3rd down to get their momentum going again.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a 3rd and 10. Here's Tua. They'll get this into the hands of Hill, complete. And he is going to have the Dolphins 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
Well, every drive from here out is definitely crucial and critical. They know that they need to get at least three here to get it back to a one-score game. But I can't imagine that in their huddle that they're thinking at all about getting a field goal. They want to get into the end zone and then try and get the ball back again.
Tua now on first down. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
And that's really difficult to do because ordinarily the safeties are back there to prevent that happening. But they found the opening and exploited it.
Lambeau to add on the extra point. It's up and good, and the lead's now down to three at 20-17. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. A little less than 4 minutes remaining, and the margin for error is small with this slim lead. Operate within your four-minute offense here, Charles?
Definitely. Remember, the four-minute offense doesn't always correspond to what's up on the clock. What they need to do is play a little bit of keep away right now. Run the clock down. Make sure their opponent doesn't get the ball back. Their dream scenario, get enough first downs and make them eat up their timeouts so the game ends when you're kneeling down with the football.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. On play action, wins. Under a heavy rush and down he goes. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout. That's going to be their second. They'll be left with one more plus the two-minute warning. And we'll be back. Another try after the first down sack. Wentz. Oh, that'll be incomplete. Oh, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down. This a very important drive, and that incompletion leads to a very important third down here if they're going to try and get the football back.
Yeah, getting it back, absolutely crucial to their chances to try and win this game. I would expect a lot of pressure here. They can't afford to let them continue to get first downs and eat away at the clock.
Third and long, they'll look to throw. This to McLaurin out on the left side. They'll wind up with 17 on that one, but they're still a bit short here for fourth. I hate to surrender the football when you're nursing a slim lead, but they're going to have to punt it away. Trust that defense.
It's the right play at this stage of the game as well. You don't need to press it here because you do have that little bit of a cushion, and you count on your D to make it stand up.
And now the punter, Tress Way, as he sends this one away. And this will carry out of bounds. Where are they going to spot it now? At about the 18-yard line, it looks like. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And you sense the tide turning. They scored, then their defense forced the punt, and now a chance to ultimately take the lead here late. Tackle made by Chase Young. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth.
Second and nine.
Tagovailoa working out of the gun. That's caught by Wilson. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 17 yards for the Dolphins there as they've got themselves a first down.
That gets them the first down, but they've still got to move quickly here.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Tua to throw. He's going to let it fly. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. It's a big play there for Miami. 58 yards.
And this is obviously a spot where you lean on your stars. Get the ball to them in open space and let them do what they do.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Here's Mostert. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow. Wow.
What a game this has been, and what a drive that was, Charles, to take the lead here late in the fourth quarter.
A partner, that's a job well done by everyone, from the players to the guys calling the plays. And if I may introduce just one downside to the mix, might be a little bit too much time left. Enough on the clock for a final last-ditch effort to try and steal this win away.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. The last series form a little disappointing, forced to punt. And now they'll try to do better here and come away with some points as they begin this drive, first and 10. To throw is Wentz. Gets this to Gibson. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and that'll bring up second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. That's number 4. Sack number 4. They had 4 last week, so he's been down on the ground a lot.
Partner, they say the eye in the sky does not lie. And that's indeed the case because they watched the game tape from the previous week, incorporated into their own defensive scheme, and continued to get after this quarterback.
And now this defense will be searching for sack number 5. Desperation throw deep downfield, and that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up 4th down.
Partner, they've got one chance left to keep this one going, and I think for you and me, let's think along with their offensive coordinator now, has to think back, cycle through every play of this contest, and remember what's worked and what hasn't, because right here, he needs the best play of the game in order to keep this one alive.
Now Wentz, gotta have this one. And the comeback may stall out. It's intercepted. Picked off by Eric Rowe. And the Dolphins are gonna take possession of the football.
Well, you knew you had to take some chances here with the clock winding down, needing a touchdown to win it. And that one might have just sealed their fate.
Yeah, and that's the nature of the 2-minute drill. The offense trying to go downfield and make their plays. But defenses, they're sitting back watching everything that they do.
but not too far back. They want to be in position to make a play on the ball, and that they did.
That was an excellent come-from-behind victory, Charles, especially there in the fourth quarter. Both offense and defense were clicking. They're going to feel good about this one.
Boy, are they ever, because the deficit they faced certainly wasn't small. They obviously did not give up on that one, and in the end, how about that come-from-behind victory? They'll cherish this one for a while.
So for the Dolphins, they run their mark to 6-2 on the year. And they'll get another road date next week as their opponents will be the New York Jets. Meanwhile, for Washington, the turnaround hasn't materialized as they fall to 2-7. And they'll have a tough one at home next week against the Denver Broncos.